This video shows how to use the free Trace32 debugger for Arduino Portenta H7 in order to flash and debug the included ready-to-run demos. Please refer to our video Trace32 GDB Front-End Debugger for Portenta H7 Part 1 for information about downloading and configuring Trace32 for Arduino Portenta H7. The free Trace32 debugger for Arduino Portenta H7 includes a number of pre-built demo programs. These demos can be accessed from the Portenta H7 Demos menu. The Trace32 demo directory already includes the ELF and binary files of these demos. ELF files contain debug symbols, which are required for debugging, while binary files can be programmed into the board flash memory and can run directly on the board's hardware. Let's start with a T32 thread debug. This demo is based on Arduino thread debug example. A dialog called ELF file selection will appear. This dialog will search for available examples inside the directory corresponding to the selection under options. The first two selections correspond to the installation directory of the respective Arduino IDE. By selecting current dir, the debugger will search for ELF files inside the current directory of the started demo. The list to the right gets populated with the available ELF files. The dialog could find here a single ELF file. We can select the file with a double click. The file attributes at date, time, and size will be displayed in the top of the dialog window. If the application has already been programmed to flash, for instance, via the Arduino IDE or a previous Trace32 session, select Load Debug Symbols. Program is already in flash to prevent an unnecessary erase and write cycle of the on-chip flash memory. Otherwise, select Flash Program and Load Debug Symbols. You can expand the instruction field for more details about the different options of the ELF file selection dialog. Click the OK button to confirm all of your choices and start the session. Before programming the flash memory, Trace32 will ask you to double-click the reset button on the board in order to enable the bootloader mode. The built-in green LED of the Portenta fades in and out when in bootloader mode. Click the Yes button to proceed. Diagnostic messages will be displayed in the Trace32 area window whilst the erasing and programming take place. The script will then attach to the Portenta H7 and open some debug windows. This demo includes a function that calculates a sine wave and stores the results in an array. You can display this array graphically by doing a right mouse click on the array name, then selecting Other View Graphical. If we place a breakpoint on line 44 and resume the execution, we can see how the array is filled. If you want to do this automatically, you can place a spot breakpoint instead of a normal breakpoint. A spot breakpoint halts the execution shortly in order to update the Trace32 screen. As soon as the screen is updated, the program execution is resumed. If we start the program execution, we see how the array is updated. If you want to additionally display the memory contents, do a right mouse click on sine wave, then select Display Memory Dump. You can highlight the changed memory by doing a right mouse click on the Data Dump window header, then adding the option Spotlight. You can also display the content of local variables by selecting the menu view Locals. Please refer to the document ICD tutorial for more information about the Trace32 PowerView user interface. This document can also be opened from the menu Help. We also recommend to watch our video tutorials available on the Lauterbach YouTube page for more information about the features of the Trace32 PowerView user interface. Let's start the second demo. This demo implements a software-based trace logger, which is useful in case you need to observe function call sequences or variable values. The Trace32 logger is much less intrusive than a normal printf and does not require a serial port, and let you measure accurate, relative, and absolute timing with microsecond accuracy. We need to follow the same steps explained previously. In this demo, we are logging the entries of some functions, as well as the values of the variables fastCount and slowCount. Let's test this by executing the program for a couple of seconds. The recorded data can be displayed by pressing the list window from the logger dialog. We can see fetch cycles, which correspond to the executions of the logged functions, and write cycles, which correspond to the variable accesses, with the corresponding data. Trace32 offers various display options of the recorded data. By pressing the chart button, you can, for example, display a graphical chart of the recorded functions. Let's move on to the third and last demo. In this demo, a second serial port over USB has been defined for printing. The Trace32 term window is then used to connect this to the serial port. The serial ports are automatically detected by the demo script. If we step through the code, we can see the messages printed in the serial terminal window. Thank you for your attention. I will show you in the next video how to program and debug your own demo with a free Trace32 debugger for Portenta H7.